So in this session, we're going to basically, if you're a Sage estimating user, we're going to show you a few things that you can do to your database and system to basically make these transfers work better in the future. So this is the estimate that we used when we transferred to BidMetrics just a moment ago. And basically, we went through and did the estimate, and then we came back and set up some WBS codes for the bid package and bid package phase. And we basically put all our different code numbers and things like that in this job. So ultimately, going forward, we set these up for takeoff for an estimate. But ultimately, they probably make sense to be set up in the database, so that way you can use them over and over on future estimates. So I'm going to go to my database, and I'm going to set those same couple things up on now, this is also where you probably go to edit variables, and you probably set up your standard library here. So I'm not going to go through how to actually import them in this video. Make sure to check up our YouTube channel. There's one on importing uniformat, which is the exact same concept. So it shows you how to come in here and hit import and bring in a bunch of different values and so forth, so that we can actually import these from a list and so forth. In my case, I'm going to only worry about the couple of them that I've got in this particular job. So I'm just going to really add just my concrete and my couple headings there. And then I'm going to come back and maybe catch a couple other headings on this side of it. So I'm going to come back in and say, okay, so I've got some sort of a library set up of these and so forth. So now there's a few different ways of getting those into the database. So basically, by making them set on the database, it makes it where if I went to right click on this item and I said edit this item in the database, it's added a WBS field here where it now has this bid package and bid package phase, where now you can go through and actually code every single item in your database to have some starting point. So some items, maybe I don't put a bid package on because I don't really bid them for bid days or something of that nature, or maybe they change so often what bid package I like them in. I can always leave them blank, but I can also always come back in here and, you know, do move copy and change around on a job by job basis. So one of the little secrets that I'm going to take a look at is if I actually go through and insert another column here, there's another column up here called update database, which apparently I missed. Let's run it again. So now I'm going to go through and say everything under there and everything under there, I want to update the database from this estimate. So I spent the time to code out all these items on this particular job. So under my data from estimate, it lets me pick what fields I want to update. So this is a great tool for updating prices or things like that back to your database. In this case, I want to update my bid package and my bid package phase. Going to come up with an audit trail. That's fine. It's going to generate some stuff. It's done 21 item updates. That's fine. So now if I take a look at my database, what that has basically done is that has actually went through and actually put this estimate's values in for that automatically. So that way it's already got my bid package, already got my bid phase that I just looked at a moment ago that was blank, but it took the work I did on this estimate and pushed that back to the database. So future estimates, these items would already be coded. Now, keep in mind also, I'm not going to go through it because there's just some YouTube videos on it on using Database Editor. Those columns are available for Database Editor that you can, you know, pre-fill and all that good stuff. But I'm going to show one other thing here just to kind of confirm what we just did. So I'm just going to leave that at some garbage estimate. One's fine. And I'm just going to kind of flip right back into doing some takeoff with that same model that I generated that other estimate by. So we'll just rattle some numbers through here again. Whoops. Whatever it may be, go, generate, go. So that way it generated the same amount of takeoff. Now I didn't set my sequences up as a standard one, so that's another thing I'm going to take a look at here. So, you know, when we went into that other job, we set up sequences and we added one for bid item and bid item package and bid item phase. Now, this is something that going forward, I probably want to take the extra time and go to my database and set those same sequences up in my database so all future estimates would have this bid package and bid package phase. I'm not going to necessarily go do that, but you know, all you have to do is hit edit, add, and you can set them up. And that way on the future, you know, any future estimates would automatically have this tab. And as you can see, all the stuff that I just deleted from that first estimate that I did it is, you know, not coded, but everything else already has its bid package. So this would be very easy to then export it out like we showed earlier, get that into bid metrics to make this even easier once you get, you know, your items coded out in your database. So that's what I want to take a look at here, just the better methods of getting some of that content in the database so we don't have to reinvent the wheel every time that we send an estimate over to BidMetrics.